Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to show you how to use Bing Chat. This is an AI chatbot from Microsoft based on the popular ChatGPT using version 4. Now, you can do so many different things on the web with Bing Chat, and I'm using it completely free. This is like having a free personal assistant. Now, one of the things I do want to show you first today is the new DALL E 3 in there, where you can just be typing out text and getting images back, or maybe you want to drag an image to do a search, or extract words from an image. All these can be done in Bing Chat. I also want to show you the other great features in Bing Chat, so stick around today as we go through this step by step. So how do we access Microsoft Bing Chat? Well, just go to bing.com. I'll put the link also down below in the description. And then you'll notice that we have chat right here. If I select chat, it brings me directly to it. Now, at this point, I'm using Microsoft Edge, and this will work on any browser, but the conversation you can get a little bit longer with Microsoft Edge. The other thing I like about using Microsoft Edge, it's built into the browser. So if you look into the top right-hand corner, this icon here, if I select this, it opens up Bing right here. So whatever web page I'm on, I can always have access to it very easily. And you can see how we have the same options available to us. Another way you can access it is through your phone, download the app. It's a great way to always have it on you if you're doing some searching on your phone. And if you have the newest version of Microsoft Windows 11, you can access it through Copilot built right in. So today though, I'm just gonna focus on this right here using the chat inside here, but feel free to try some of those other options. Not that you have to sign in or create an account for using Bing Chat, but you are able to ask more questions and have longer conversations, and then they'll also get saved. I am going to sign in, and I'm just using a free account to do this. You'll notice the sign-ins here, or you can go up top, sign in with what type of account you want. So I'm going to go get signed in before we start playing with some of these creating images from words. So I'm all logged into one of my accounts. I actually logged into one of my business ones. I just want to show you the difference of what it looks like, but it does all the same things. Now, the first thing that I wanted to do was show you DALL E 3. So this is an image creator from just typing text in. Let's say I have a new business. It's a pet grooming business called Pooch House, and I want to create some logos for this, and I want some ideas generated. So I'm just going to put this in. So I'm starting a new pet grooming business called Pooch House. Can you come up with 3 logo ideas? I could ask for more. I could go ahead and ask for, I could ask for more after and kind of change the prompt a bit. So here it goes, creating the ideas of the different possibilities here. And then after it creates these ideas, it's going to create me some images as well. So if it doesn't come up with that, if it just gives you the ideas, if you're creating other images, you might have to say create visuals for this after in the prompt, and then it will go through and create. So this will be done in just a moment. Doesn't take very long at all. You can see some examples. I could ask it to create 4 more. I could specify maybe some things that I'd like to see in it. But if I go ahead and click on one of these, I can go through and see them larger just by arrowing through. But this gives me a great starting point. If I wanted to save them, I could just go ahead and right click save image as. So go ahead and try it, try in the prompt asking for some visuals and seeing how specific you could get to for what it creates. And you can see right here, it's powered by DALL E 3. So go ahead and give that a try. This time, I want to go and add an image to this and ask it a question to do something. So to add an image, if we go add an image right here, if we just click on this, we have some options. You could put a URL in here. We could upload from this device or take a photo. Now, what I'm going to do, I have right on my desktop this photo right here. I'm just going to drag it and drop. So it's that easy to add the images to this. Now let's go ahead and ask it something. I want to know what type of dog breed this is. I'm going to hit enter. Now as it goes through, it's going to analyze what they think this picture is and give me back information about this. So not only will it tell me what type of dog breed, it usually gives me a little bit more information about it as well. So it found that it's a black Labrador retriever. And you can see as it goes through, it gives me some information about these two. So as I click, I can see that they're cited. So if I click on this, it's going to take me to the website that it pulled that information off. So I like that it has those sources to it. So give that with try with some of the images that you have. Just drag it and ask it a question to find about that one. Let's use Bing Chat now to help us solve a problem, kind of help us get ready for a project that we want. Now, before I go and just ask it something in a new topic, I just want to point out we have some options here as I hover over. If I go and select, let's say, creative, notice the color changes and the background changes as well. It lets me know what I'm on just by looking at the background. Now, as I hover over any of these, you can see clear your conversation and start an original imaginative chat. We have clear your conversation, start an informative and friendly chat, or do you want to be have that straightforward chat? So depending what you want, you can go ahead and play with each of these to kind of know what you're getting back. Now, I'm just going to go and we'll do this one at first. Notice when I have this selected, if we take a look at the very bottom, this number changes. If I go to this one, it's 2000. These are the characters of how much I can put in down here. I'm going to start and put some question in here. So what I wanted to do is create a project management schedule for creating a website for my pooch house business. Also, what I like about this, notice that the microphone is right here. So if you do want to just talk into it and have that conversation, you could go ahead and use the microphone. But I can go ahead and submit or hit enter. I've only used 89 of the 4,000, but I'm going to go ahead and submit it. Now, as this takes a moment, it will go through and generate. It will search. It's searching through the web. Now it's going to break it down kind of the different steps. What I really like about this is how it will give me all the sources at the very bottom here. So once this is done here, notice that we have, this is where it got the information from, right here. So if I wanted to kind of check deeper into any of those sources, I could go into this. Now, the other thing what I want to point out here is that I can go ahead and keep asking it more questions. This one of 30 is going to be kind of in this strand right here that as I go through, I can ask it up to 30 questions. So if I was going to go and ask it something else now, I'll just, what would be a good scheduler? And if I hit enter, it's going to go look for some of these schedulers, some apps that I could use. And what I wanted to point out was look at how the number is now 2 of 30. So you have up to 30 that you can go through as you go through each of these. Another great thing I like about when you're creating any of these, when I hover over, you have some information. You can like it. This will help to let it know whether it's doing a good job or not. Dislike. I can go ahead and copy this information if I needed to paste it. I can export this. So look at this. So if I go to export, I could edit this in Word, download as a PDF or text. So I get those options. I could share this very easily out through here as well. So you can also continue on your phone. So some great options. Now with any of these, if I look over to the right up here, I could see my history that I can go back. So if I wanted to go back to any of the ones that I was looking at before, there it is. So that was the dog one I was showing you when I was searching. The history is all up there and I can go ahead and delete these or edit. If I wanted to name them differently, I can go ahead and just click edit and change the name as well. So just hit the check mark when you're done. And you also have the options to export and share there as well. So go ahead and try some questions of how this can help you using Chat Bing here to kind of get your feel around it. If you're ready for a new topic and you don't want to be in this thread, go ahead and just click new topic and then you'll be at the start also again where you're going to be one of 30 and all your ideas that are saved over here. The last thing what I want to show you today is Bing Chat built into Microsoft Edge. And I really like using it this way. So I'm going to go to a website here, just this NASA one, And I'm going to go ahead and open up Bing Chat. So I showed you at the very beginning, just in the top right-hand corner in Microsoft Edge, then this pops up. And so we see all the same things that if we wanted to use, whether it be creative, balanced, or precise, I can go ahead and ask it anything. I can use the microphone. I can up input, I can put the images in, just like all the different things I showed you before. What I really like about using this way, if you want some summations of this page, and even already it's giving me a page summary for NASA here on this page. If I go ahead and maybe I pick this one over here, now it's giving me a summary for this page right through here. So instead of running, you know, instead of kind of reading this all at the beginning, I get to know, you know, is this kind of what I'm looking for? Now, if this isn't being generated, go ahead and just ask it to generate a page review for the page you're on. Just type that. Just go down and say summarize the page. I have asked it to do that before, so it's probably remembering that I did do that. And then it's going to sum up all of those for you. So that can be a real time saver if you're going through a lot of information on websites to know what that certain page is about. The other thing I just want to point out in here with the compose, if you want to write something really quickly, go ahead, just put in your prompt up here. What tone do you want this to be? You could add your own tone as well. Is this going to be a paragraph, an email, ideas, a blog post? So you can really set the context for these, short, medium, long, and then go ahead and just hit generate your draft, and then it will be down here and you can copy paste it out of there as well. And then I just do want to point out the insights. So on this page that I'm on right now, if I go to insights, it will kind of give me information about the different ones that I'm on. So if I go and just click on an update, and then I'll go, let's say this one right here, and you see that it gives me the information where, you know, maybe it's key phrases, other links to this one. So if you're searching for, you know, searching on the web, this can really help you kind of find more information. It can sum up that information and really save you a lot of time. So let me know what you think about Microsoft Edge. If you haven't used it before, give it a try. Try Bing Chat built right into it like this and see how useful it is for you. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.